chedomte India wangin na mani toy on na yin tan puinate kan lam mo fo do na ni a so wangin so mula te po so an voi nan poka urta ka in ron telzel kan du sat seu ani an sai tong khan e women's study center yan pe chia te chang kan na zel tur le mi pa te ne la in kung kai na in kara te thazok te om ze the na tur te le eng eng mo tu na kan la ngai tua chen pa lo te po center ron thang ze la nga kan society a be pa in kan la thang chau ze la nga thil thar har sat na thar te e mo ti tur thar te alo la piang ze lo na di zung 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 te chu zira research ritla takte tia me chetan aming chu de ba sala me chala mi pa mi so som ta da center hian na atho kan za atlok na kan tel fit the kan be se ya so mi chu be se chu win he center te hi we de hian kan na hong ani a a hong tan na chau ala ni a kan pa ti tur tam takalom do na su zong zong wa chuan vai na local te le local thei lo te zong zong po in pui na le in advice te in thoron te kan la mo mo fo do na su zong zong fo na kan mo mo fo na po chuan pu taka in riat na le in thei na te in ron tho zel turin kan nge ngal bok cheu ani as I said I don't think I'll say much because the two speakers have already mentioned, I think, what is required for today. And we are going to hear also some short speeches from about five or six invitees. So I'll not take much of their time. So once again, I thank all of you, and I hope this center will grow with your blessings for the benefit of the people of Mizoram and also particularly the women. So with these few words, I have the pleasure to inaugurate this women UGC sponsor Women Studies Center in Mizoram University. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the enlightening and encouraging speech, and we applaud you for your care,
redeemer and liberator of our life. Today is a very different day for MZU and for people in Mizoram as a whole. We thank you for giving us this day, the day in which we inaugurate Women's Study Center here at MZU. We have been praying for this when the PMSA Core Committee decided in 2009 and even went to the VC and discussed together and memorandum submitted. We found that was a long process, but then today that long process has come to its reality. The baby has born. Thank you, O Lord. This is your marvelous work. O Lord, we thank you so much for whatever you have done to us. We thank you for giving us the VC that has the same concern, the same zeal, the same interest to have this Women's Study Center here in the MZU. We also want to give thanks to you, Dr. Lale Zoe, who has spared her effort without any problem, without tiredness, for her rendering of service tirelessly, and for all other core committee members, and for all other professors here who are also rendering their best, and also for all other committee members, even the MHEP and State Social Welfare, and also for all other women's societies. For all those who are supporting this and to those who are praying for this, Lord, we thank you for this. But without your help, this cannot move forward. I just want to commit all of them into your mighty hand. Thank you for the VC who will be leaving the MZU soon, continue to bless him and guide him, his family members, and also Dr. Lerna Izovi. Lord, continue to bless her as she is coordinating this study center. And be with all the professors here, her friends, her colleagues, and also all the students who will be taking up these studies, so that, Lord, they will be really developed in the true sense of the term. They will be empowered so that there will be cordiality, there will be equality, and also peace and harmony in our families, in our churches, and in our society, and in the colleges, in the institutions, and in the university. Lord, we thank you for everything. And this time, whatever we have heard, bless for all of us. And as we depart from this place, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet communion of the fellow of the triune God rest and abide with us now and always. Amen. Thank you. Please be seated.
The women dignity. Okay, this is the best part to propose a vote of thanks. On behalf of the Mizoram University fraternity, we are really thankful to you all. Firstly, let me say heartfelt thanks to our Vice Chancellor, Professor Lathan Kluanga. You know, he looks like, he looks very humble and all, but he's a man. He's a man, you know. Even if you give a great pressure or hard pressure, he will listen it, he might not do it that, you know, until and unless he's convinced that. Okay, and you know, in this, especially in this women's studies also, he knows what he has to do and when to do and how to do. Under his guidance, now we are getting the result of that's his, what all he have done. And he's been giving his days and life for the academic advancement. And now he's going to complete tomorrow, tomorrow's going to be his last day, and because of that I wanted to extend that and all that. So with this Women's Study Center, so we are really thankful to you. We'll remember you that whenever we come to know the name of that University Women's Study Center, we'll remember you, sir. We thank you. We thank you so much for that. Yeah. On this day, I would like to mention about, I would like to acknowledge the contribution of that. Mrs. Lelding Liani Silo. She is the member of the National Commission for Women. And he also came and visited the Vice Chancellor, not only of that, and all. He keep talking us that where the things that are proposal lying and all. And then he talked to the concerned person, being the colleague of her. And he plea and pursue. And, you know, those who could give that permission to this Women's Study Center. We're really thankful to that Mrs. Lalding Liani Silo. And today, we all are hearing about the testimony of all of those government dignitaries and civil societies, what all they have given, or whatever they have input for the upcoming of this Women's Study Center. We're really thankful to you all, and especially that my university fraternities also at all level, they keep helping us whatever, whenever it's required to do something and whatever, you know, they keep helping us. And today, they already testify what all they have given input to that. You know, this is really a time only to say thank you to, because I just could not find an appropriate word to say thank you to you all. Anyway, you already testify what all you have done for the coming up of this Women's Studies Center. At the last, you know, being the human being, we have made a plan, a future plan. We have designed the strategies, whatever we think is going to be good and all. But without the help of that, without the blessing of our Heavenly Father, we couldn't complete. And because of that, today we are going to have a rightful person who could give us that benediction. We're really thankful to you, that Reverend Dr. Aaron Nooney. Thank you so much for your, thank you so much.
To bring our program to its closure, may I call upon the first woman to be Mizo.
Respected Chairman and the Chief Guest, the Vice Chancellor. Actually, I was not supposed to come and stand up here and give a speech, but since the All Mizoram Women's Federation President, Dr. Jane R. Ralte, could not come due to, I think, certain unavoidable circumstances in the family, they have called me up here, and actually, I'm not prepared to give a good, long, and lengthy speech like the ones before me. But I would like to congratulate the Mizoram University on being able to open the, to inaugurate the Women's Studies Center today. I think it is a giant leap for women of Mizoram, and it is a one step forward in women empowerment, that I call it. And I think I would like to mention here that men today also, when the men came up, they spoke, they stood straight, they looked all around and gave their speech. But when the women came up, I'm not saying that they're not good enough, but I'm saying that how we hold ourselves when we come to the stage and speak is just shows that we women are not confident as yet. So I think the Women's Studies Center would later on, as it moves on, empower women and make them confident young people. Will, and not only the women folks I'm talking about, whoever studies in the center will become more confident. And women, especially when we come, how we hold ourselves, how we stand, how we look around, matters so much to show that we are confident. So I wish, and the All Mizoram Women's Federation, on behalf of the All Mizoram Women's Federation, I wish the Women's Study Center all the best. Thank you so much for inviting me up here. Though I'm not prepared, I hope you got what I'm trying to get through. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
2014 was enacted and it became an act. But the act was only carried out, which could be implemented, that was in 13th February 2015. So it has come a long way after the customary law, which had seen the women as a low profile than men. And many of the times we had domestic violence, and oftentimes the problem arises. So because of that, as government of India had passed the Domestic Violence Act in 2005, and this was implemented by our government of Mizoram since 2007. So in our MHEP, we had taken up this project of Domestic Violence Act, wherein we have social workers, two in number. So they come, the parents or the mother comes along with the children, or the mother comes alone with complaining of all types of difficulties. So our social workers, they try to resolve they have the counseling done, and they try to see the level best that unity comes in the family. So at times we had to take them to the court. So there are many occasions wherein some result has been done and some taken to the court. And we have also a project called Prevention of Parent-to-Child Transmission of HIV/AIDS. So this is under the global funding. We have taken up pregnant women are tested for HIV, and the children, at birth, they are being again tested till the age of 18 months. So here also, we had about a number of mothers who had been tested, but for positive HIV and AIDS is very rare. It's rather almost minimal, and especially for the child to become positive. We had about only 1-2 cases, so it was really a blessing. Here we had also taken up anti-tobacco projects, wherein we had the Gutkha products, where our Honorable Chief Minister's missus, she is the President of the Indian Society Tobacco and Health, so she had inaugurated for us to work on the ill effects of Gutkha products. That was way back in 2010. So from then on, we had the and the government has also taken up, and presently we have the Mizoram Society on Tobacco Society Control, for which this work has been very much expedited, and in every district this has also been taken up. And now presently we are having this Gutkha product control has also been issued by the government, for which work has been taken up, and the branches wherein we have in the whole state about 730 branches, and each of them takes care of in their respective villages or in the towns. And here's now that the government is very much alert on these tobacco products, so we have anti-tobacco squad and other means for protecting the children from this. And we also have a theme on protection of women and child for a betterment of their health care. So, and that theme is now carried on. So every time we visit the block conference or the sub-headquarters conference, there we have the themes working on. And here we too have the legal advisors, two in number, in our office. So they are very helpful in all the legal works. So they are guiding us. So, and then we have the monthly magazine of Runlum. Here in Runlum, we try our level best to see that communication is possible through this, so that they give us their reports whenever there is some new leaders are voted. So the reports are given in this Runlum and other activities, and regarding the child and women welfare. So many write-ups has been done, and a circular is given monthly. And we have the computer concept course on computer concepts certificate course, and this has been tied up with NILIT. As you know, it's located in Zhuangtui, and the director is very eager to help us out. So here we collected the names of our beneficiaries from our different branches or sub-headquarters or our block and joints. Here we have now presently more than 100 students coming to our office institute. Institute means the building wherein we are located in Treasury Square. Here they come and they have the courses 1 hour daily. So in a day we have about 100 students. So and 20 computers are being provided to us. The only thing that we have done is provide the space. So we have about 20 students per hour. So we run about 5 hours in a day. So total there are 100 students in one day. And the course period is 3 months. So within the 3 months, this course on conception of computer certificate can be given. So after the period of 3 months, exams are conducted. So there are about benefits who are in this. There are more than presently, we have last year about 60 students have passed out. So it is really a privilege on our part to have such an occasion to have the free training course on computer because they, most of them could not afford it, so they are also very happy. So as I have told earlier, we are, since most of you may not be aware about our establishment, we have 7 sub-headquarters, 23 blocks, then 20 joints, and 730 branches spread all over Mizoram. And the government is also keen to have us involved in all the departments like social welfare. Social welfare is a department that we are very closely linked with. There we had our Maite Room, that is an orphanage located in Zemabok. So our orphanage is now solely for adoption. We have about 10 beds. Now recently we have about 6 children. So one of our child who had hair lip, cleft lip, because of his hair lip, he had split here, and his palate, he cannot take any food, he cannot be breastfeeded. So his mother wrapped him, but the social workers in Mamit, they came and then they had protected him. So it reached to us on the 15th day of his birth. So that child has been given repaired, his hair lip has been repaired, palate has been repaired by the smile train who used to come in Greenwood Hospital. So we are given free treatment. So we are very thankful to the smile train people. So we are very thankful to them. And this very child has been taken to by parents who cannot, who are in a very tight position because they would like to have child. So a couple from Finland had just taken him to Finland. So recently, just last week, in Saturday, they came and took him. So this was done through the International Country Adoption Agency. So we are very thankful for this. And presently, we have also another 2 children who will be taken to Denmark. The documents are on the process. And to New Zealand. New Zealand, our child is also having heart problem. But she was operated in Escorts, Delhi. So she is presently quite healthy. And we are expecting her also to be released by this coming month, by this month in May. So we are very thankful to God for all that we could take care and also for giving them childless mother and parents to have such children to adopt them to a faraway place. So we are very thankful. And here as Women's Center, we feel that this is would go a long way for MHEP, General Headquarters, with all its branches. It will really be a benefit. And I really thank Mizoram University and especially our Vice Chancellor for his painstaking work that he has taken up. So it is for our part to be really very thankful. So I thank you all for this.
Thank you, ma'am, for that very informative speech.
Respected Chairperson, Professor Lerner Yusavi, our Chief Guest, Professor Arnold Tamitwanga, Honorable Vice Chancellor, distinguished guests, and friends. It is a great privilege for me to have a short speech on the occasion of the inauguration of Women's Studies Center in the Mizoram University. As we all know, Women's Studies Center is our long-felt need for imparting gender sensitivity and women's perspectives, not only to students, but and researchers, but to policymakers through relevant education. As we are all aware, the Mizoram State Commission for Women was set up in the year 1998. Since its inception, the Commission has been taking various steps to fulfill its mandates. Here, I would like to admit that there are certain issues which the Commission alone could not address to. We look forward to working with the Women's Study Center so that we can together adequately address the present and emerging issues. And this would not only contribute to knowledge building, but also academically strengthen the Women's Study Center in the process and thereby promoting sustainable development goals. And we can build an effective collaborative partnerships in organizing extension activities, especially for women in the villages and in remote areas, and in promoting awareness regarding their special programs for women, their rights and laws related to them, through seminars, workshops, conferences on women issues and gender inequality, for obtaining different views and opinions from cross-sections of a society in order that our partnership may formulate suitable recommendations of government. I, on behalf of the State Commission, congratulate and wish the Women's Studies Center, Mizoram University, much success and a great future. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Let us now request Dr. Arla Nunmoyi to kindly come on stage and deliver her short speech. Dr. Arla Nunmoyi is a superintendent of the Protective Home and Reception Center under the Department of Social Welfare, Government of Mizoram.
Respected Chairperson, Professor Lal Nezavi, Head Department of Public Administration, and Honorary Director, Women's Studies Center, MZU, Honorable Chief Guest, Professor Lal Thantuang, our Vice Chancellor, MZU, other dignitaries, and my friends. It is a great honor and privilege for me to speak from the Department of Social Welfare, Government of Mizoram. There are more likely persons in mind to address such a gathering on such an auspicious occasion. I therefore take this opportunity to thank the organizers for inviting me to do the honor. I assume that we all agree that women in most societies, including our own, face issues and problems which are very different from men, just for the simple reason of being born a woman. Our department has witnessed the problems faced by women in our society through its various work and the issues that touch upon their lives. The plight of pregnant and nursing mothers, destitute women and their children, the situations faced by women who are victims of domestic violence, which may be emotional, physical, or otherwise. The additional complexity of societal dynamics concerning women with addiction problem, including alcoholism and female sex work. These are some concerns, to highlight a few. The initiative of Mizoram University to set up the Women's Study Center is a call for celebration. I believe the center will serve as a resource and nodal center for the region, and true to its mandate, developed as a strong academic center of teaching and learning, generating new thinking and knowledge. We hope the center will conduct research-based studies which will initiate a series of actions to transform social consciousness, to offer an environment of learning and teaching which hopefully will remain within the limits of the university, but impact the society it seeks to reach. The Department of Social Welfare is already closely associated with the Mizoram University through the Department of Social Work. By placing their students every year for their fieldwork placement, likewise, the Department of Social Welfare is open to work with Women's Studies Center to promote the welfare of women. I, on behalf of the Department of Social Welfare, once again commend the Vice Chancellor, Mizoram University, and I congratulate all the key and committed persons who have been striving for the existence and functioning of Women's Studies Center at MZU. I wish the Women's Studies Center grow to achieve which it has set out to accomplish. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for that. Good wishes. May I now call upon Dr. Than Pui, the Vice President of the General Headquarters, Mizo Meitse in Sui Kompol, to kindly deliver a short speech. Dr. Than Pui is also presently holding the post of the Director at Ripons.
Thank you, Ms. The Honorable Chairperson, Professor Lan Naizubi, our respected Vice Chancellor, Professor A. La Thantluanga, our Technical Program Speech on Women's Studies, Professor Srinivas Pathi, Dean, and I was told he is the senior most professor in the university, Professor T. Vanantani, who is Anzal Theological College professor, and for her speech, I really thank for the importance that she had mentioned regarding the this inauguration of Women's Studies Center at MZU. And I also address my speech to Ms. Lalbiakimi, Member Secretary, Mizoram State Commission for Women, Dr. R. Lalunmoi, Superintendent, Protective Home, DSW, Government of Mizoram. And I would like to thank all the organizers, especially our Vice Chancellor, who had taken painstaking really to have this established in the university of our very own, in the state, Central University of Mizoram University. And I'm sure this will go a long way. So here I really congratulate all the persons that are involved in this success, for the success of this ongoing study for the Women Center. I'm really honored to be here in this August gathering for this auspicious occasion. I have seen the university growing since I was the director of Ripons way back in 2004, and I was there till 2009. And I had to come here for different courses, for our Bachelor in Medical Laboratory Technology, for Bachelor in Pharmacy, Bachelor in Radio Imaging, and for which we had been having a very good contact. And presently, I am now the Vice President of the Mizo Meitse in Sui Kompol. This is one of the biggest organization in the state. And this very establishment of the Women's Studies Center in MZU, I'm sure it will go a long way for the success and for the real privilege for the women of Mizoram. And also, I'm sure not just the women, but also the male part. So here, I really thank the organizers. Here I would like to mention a few things regarding our performances in our establishment as Mizo Meitse in Sui Kompol. Mizo Meitse in Sui Kompol is established in 6th July 1974, and that was way back, so we had already celebrated our Ruby Jubilee, that is the 40th year, that was last in 2014 on 26th February, and 6 July. So it has come a long way. And during this period, we have seen many presidents and their OBs. So one of the prominent president of MHEP is here with us, Pirin Twangi. She had got a long tenure of being president, and she was also the secretary. And here too we have B. Sankumi. She had also given most of the time for the development of this MHEP. So MHEP has been already more than 40 years. So during this period, there are many occasions wherein, because of our customary law, we had to, it has struggled a long way, but last November 2014, the cabinet has approved and passed that the bill of marriage, divorce, and inheritance property bill of
Very good morning to all of you. And on my own behalf and on behalf of Mizoram University, I welcome all of you to Mizoram University and also to this function. I'm happy that the representatives of so many organizations, NGOs, and institutions are here to share our this moment of joy and to come and be with us on this very important inaugural function of Women's Study Center. Pitlani has already mentioned how this Women's Study Center was initiated by their organization, and I think different organizations, women organizations, also must have lent their moral support to all these people who have worked for this. Yeah, when I joined in 2011, I think I don't remember the date when some of the representatives like Pitlani, Pidaizovi, and Pinuni, and others came and met me, telling me that they have already submitted the proposal for establishment of Women's Study Center in Mizoram University. But when I tried to pursue, that was towards the fag end of the 11th plan of UGC. And UGC had already, I think, done whatever they had to do. And when the 12th plan period began, I inquired UGC, what about our proposal? They said, we have not yet called proposals for Women Study Center. So whenever I went to Delhi, I asked them whether this proposals have been already invited. So one day, they told me that they have already invited the proposals for Women Study Center, and they have not fixed also the last date for submission of the proposal. So immediately I contacted Professor Lalne Izavi to prepare the proposal, and when I our proposal was ready, I took it to UGC, but we did not get any communication from UGC. So whenever I went to Delhi, I inquired the UGC office who deal with these proposals. So then when I went, I think sometime in, when was that? September or when? So they told me that the interaction meeting will be held on such and such a day. Unfortunately, that day was the time, I mean, when we had our selection meetings, and Professor Lalne Izavi was to be part of this selection committee for our faculties. So we have asked UGC to postpone the date of interaction by one day so that she can participate, because she was the one who has prepared, maybe with the help of others, the proposal. So luckily, UGC agreed to delay, postpone our interaction, our university interaction with them by one day, so she could go and make interaction with the expats committee for establishment of this Women's Service Center. So that is how this was proposed and how we have taken steps for the establishment. And fortunately, the UGC has granted us this Women's Study Center. So I think we are all happy. It is all the combined efforts of all those well-wishers of MZU, the well-wishers of this Women's Study Center. Now it is only the beginning, and we have still to do so many things. And I would request all of you to give your advice, help, and suggestions, even when the center actually started functioning. Because the UGC has not yet sanctioned the money yet, the fund yet, only they have sanctioned the center. Last week, I went to UGC again, and when I inquired, they say they have already prepared all the financial proposals and all, and it will be done very soon. And we may get the grants only in June. That's what the person who was in charge told me. Anyhow, whatever, at the time, I think it will come. And now there is no way the UGC would withdraw unless we work for maybe the next 5 years. Depending on our performance, there will be a review. Until then, I think the next 5 years or so, we'll have this center. And I'm sure with your cooperation and your help, guidance, this center will continue even in the subsequent plans and years. Professor Pathy and Professor Tlani have already mentioned about the functioning and what the Women's Center is going to do. So I don't think I will say much. As Pitani has said, this is not only for women. In fact, these days many people say we should change the nomenclature. We should not say Women's Study Center or Women's Center. We should make it as a Gender Study Center or Gender Center or whatever you call it. They say we should not all the time talk only women. It is the gender equality, and it sometimes even men need attention. Anyhow, UGC has not changed the nomenclature. That's why it is still called Women Study Center. Anyhow, whatever, what is there in the name, as it is said, so it may be Women Study Center, so many other gender issues involving even men may be, I think, studied in this center, because studying women alone may not help the better understanding or correlation between men and women. So I think we have to do also some research on men also. So I do not know. It will depend on the people at the heads of affairs, how they try to take this center. So I think let us see. We only see now on paper the actual working. I think even as Pitlani said, men have to be very much involved. And I hope this center will be benefiting not only scholars, but all the people in general. Even our member of that women commission, P. Dingy, had come here some time ago before we got this center sanction. She wanted our university to do research on this gender and women issues. Then we told her that we are applying for this center. As soon as we get this center sanctioned, then we can prepare some projects. And I think from there, Women Commission, National Women Commission also, they have already identified certain, probably, issues on which our university can do research. I think we'll have to work with them also, and also with all the NGOs and organizations who have been working for such a long time for the welfare of women. I'm sure we'll look forward to you and also expect your input for the smooth running and functioning of this center. So that is my appeal to all of you. I don't think I should say much because the time is a little short. Today is a very busy day for us. We have three important functions. We have already finished. That's why I could not come in the beginning at 11. I hope I'll be excused because I had one important meeting scheduled at 10 o'clock, so I could finish only before 11:30. I'm sorry that I could not witness some of the cultural programs. I'm sure they are very entertaining and very good. Heng, organization Rang Rang Te Baka, Tuivamit Te, Sakorti Chun Te, Tan Hilte, Tan MHP, EP Kuai Tu Te, Leh Mibal Te Poniang, Hun Miron Man Puya in program Tatak Te, Miron Mutir Te Te Hi, In Sungwa Kan Lo Ba, Sab Trong Te, Kan Rekim Vek Lo Bay Te Ya, Poni Se, Women's Study Center Tana Vuina, Miron Tela, Item Te, Miron Dei Sa, Vangin, In Sungwa Kan Lo Tak Beva, Amaratsu, Hildang program dang te kada ye vangin program zong song te karon mu ve te lawa sumi chung cha ga chuan in mi riat thian na ka ngen chewa te no ze la po he university a nai ber
song te hian degree lo nan ni lovin rampum siam that na na answer na te an ron mang so banga suti huna chuan me sia le mi pa in kara ramri omthin achang meisia in mipa hi amelma ama ti du da tu le te si om tu anga lo thi thin na te alo tai to anga mipa te hian meisia te tan zau zau kin an ka an ang to anga meisia in meisia chung chang asoya ngei a hlo thin te hi alo bo to anga mipa in meisia te tan anu pui le afanu te tan anu ta na ka an na chang khia mipa tam zau an lo la chua ka nga suti ang ron cherchuak tur chuan women study center hi pathian in malsom se ti hi kan du tak set ani. Let me conclude my humble speech with the following questions to be answered by all of us. One, how much are you or are we ready to contribute for the constant success of women study center? Two, how will you or we saw and put into practice our cooperation to promote WSC. Thank you all for listening.
Thank you, ma'am, for clearly bringing out the various aspects of the importance of the Women's Studies Center. May I now request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Arlal Thantluanga, to come on stage and to kindly render his inaugural speech. We are proud
of our meeting at Public Administration Department office on 16th November 2009 had resolved to submit application to the Vice Chancellor of MZU for establishment of Women's Study Center under MZU. They, with the great hope, prepared application form in the BMSA Chairperson's office, who is none other than Professor Lanay Zovi, who is appointed to be Honorary Director of Women's Study Center in this MZU. In response to this, the MZU authority intimated the BMSA Core Committee on 19th January 2010 to prepare detailed proposal for WSC. The chairperson and few members of the committee took severe, painstaking effort to prepare the proposal. After giving much effort, the following two important documents were submitted to the authority of MZU on 26th February 2010, such as, one, a requirement of Women's Study Center under Mizoram University with long list of select bibliography. Two, University Grants Commission format to be filled in by the authorities of the MZU, which may be forwarded to the University Grants Commission for consideration. The period for processing the application, proposal, and other required documents took so long in order to reach the stage of success for this WSC in MZU. It is due to the well wish of the present Vice Chancellor and hard work of some few official personnel that we come together today and celebrate the joyful occasion of the long-awaited establishment of the WSC. Now, the day of inauguration of WSC turns out, and the remarkable milestone is laid upon in the history of MZU. 7 years period seems long for those who are so eager to see the day like today. But the pain suffered by the responsible persons in MZU authority as well as UGC deserves special appreciation because they really work for the welfare of the human society in general and the community in Mizoram in particular, with the hope that something better life would come in Mizoram and the surrounding areas. The PMSA Core Committee too really deserves special appreciation due to her clear vision for Women's Study Center in MZU, for taking initiative part for the welfare of women in Mizoram and surrounding areas. It is through her effort and fulfillment of submitting all required documents to the concerned authority that WSC is to be inaugurated in MZU today. Due to the members' sacrifice of their time, energy, and wisdom, and all that they could do, they did it so for making a good provision for youngsters of future generation whom patriarchy and its implied gender barrier and discrimination would not hinder future women's emancipation and development. It is rather hope that men and women researchers and all those who get involved in the WSC would become responsible agents of creation of better relationship between two sexes of human race and even for the members of the third gender for maintaining harmonious life among all members of human community. Big number two, who will be benefited in this Women's Studies Center? The question, who will be benefited through this Women's Studies Center in MZU may be asked by some of us. Let us try to open our mind to different corners. A, institution MZU will be benefited through employment generation. Whenever new department happen to be established, UGC has to grant a huge amount for running the course for employing teachers, office staff, office equipment, and many others. By any means, employment generation has to take place and several persons will get good and responsible jobs and respectable jobs. MZU family will become bigger and better relationship will be created between members of both centers of humankind. B, male resources will be benefited. Many of human societies are patriarchal and male chauvinism remains active. liberating men to suppress, oppress, and exploit women without limit. Men cannot understand that they do wrong to their women when they do such evil against women due to lack of understanding, ignorance, and blindness. But Women's Studies Center will surely open the eyes of male researchers under this scheme and course wider to see what is good and bad in their dealing with women who are their grandma, mother, sister, wife, daughter, daughter-in-law, and granddaughters. If male members are doing unbiased research under the scheme of WSC, equal value, responsibility, importance, and respect between men and women would surely be recognized and acknowledged through proper objective study in which women would be given equal importance. Hence, male researchers would be benefited to see women as human, but not as servants of men or appendixes to men only. See, female researchers will be benefited. Female researchers, too, will be benefited because they will be inspired to see themselves as human, equal to men in value and importance, not in physical strength. Please understand this. The traditional concept of women themselves, letting them to feel inferior and subordinate to men, would be wiped off. And they will see and accept their equal freedom with that of men. In order to serve for themselves and for others, they will realize that no man can dictate them how to speak, walk, dress, or live, as they all are having same human rights endorsed by fundamental rights of Indian Constitution. In addition to the equal fundamental rights that all citizens enjoy together, taking up of educational courses under WSC would open their eyes to see and make use of all recent laws relating to their protection and security from the violence that was often caused by men, and they can help and strengthen themselves in various ways. Female researchers will see and realize their own talents, capacity, potentiality, and God-given resources that would be made use of for becoming a partner fit for their men, beloved mother, sister, wife, daughter, and granddaughter, and so on. They would learn how to be more fruitful and blessed to those who are far and near to them. They, through their research about the value of human life and interpersonal relationship, would realize more about the preciousness of their men, who may be their husbands, fathers, brothers, sons, sons-in-law, and grandsons. The more they go deeper, the more they would dig out the wealth and richness of humanity, and they would be able to show such research treasure to their men and let them think and see how nice when men and women are living together in peace with love and care for each other. The new steps will be taken for gender equity through better literature. As the law provides equal opportunity to all citizens, the courses, research to be taken up, and their future findings under the course of this WSC would make positive impact on the public in order to let people see necessity, importance, and significance of solidarity of women and men at all walks of life and services. If more women and men learn how to live and work better for human community, the public will be benefited and better society and men and women relationship would become day by day. So better literature that would help the public will be published and produced by this Women's Study Center. That is the hope. E, production of more professional persons. The moment WSC is established, there is an assurance that the center would produce more professional women and men who look at the life condition of women in family, society, politics, and economics with the critical eyes and attention. More degree holders would be produced under the guidance of qualified teachers, in order to make themselves able to work for the welfare of the society in which gender equity is found and put into function. F. Realization to the necessity of cooperation among members of MZU and outside. Although there are, we are very happy and joyful to inaugurate this WSC in this very MZU, it does not mean that only women can run this program for women. Rather, the necessity of cooperation among all teachers and staff of the university is called for, because this scheme of WSC and its future departmental program would become successful only when women and men work together with their wisdom and understanding. Let this cooperation, as started today, remains active, and let more men become the advocates for the success of this WSC. Whenever and wherever our help, attention and cooperation are sought for, let us be ever ready to raise our hands in order to work for the future success of this WSC. Sentence ni khatlek soi ila Women's Study Center hi meichia in meichia chung sang azir natur anilo. Mipale meichia ten meichia te chung sang azir natur ani a su suan thir dan thar ngai tu dan thar rilupek dan thar aron siam suakanga zirtir tu tele suta zir lai lo om tur tele azir bing na risas wa laron ti tur.
Good morning to all of you, esteemed Professor R. Lalithan Thonga, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Mizoram University, guests of the occasion, my esteemed colleagues, invitees, representatives of government and civil society, dear students, ladies and gentlemen, it's a privilege on my part to stand before you to talk on women's studies in India. Little bit out of place because Professor Jovi has told so many things, almost half of my speech is covered. So don't worry, I speak very little. So let me start with a new novel by celebrated author Shashi Deshpande. My friend Professor Boral knows very well. Even in Mizoram University, some students are doing research on Deshpande's novels. The new novel is titled Strangers to Ourselves. The novel talks about the two protagonists and goes beyond the stereotypical narrative of feminism and talks about humanism. The novel says that even the most talented, qualified and professional women face a dilemma in their life, to be or not to be. Mother, writer, mother, singer, mother, dancer. And also, at the same breath, Deshpande talks about the other woman, faceless, nameless, those who work for those protagonists. And they say that they come, they help us, and we call them maid or help, but they have also their life. In brief, our Women's Studies Center will deal with everybody, from top to bottom and bottom to top. Secondly, yesterday TP gave me one of the books on Mizoram development, land use. Inside it's just like stereotypes, the likes development, then Mizoram is a land of peace, everything should happen. But the cover page is very important. I could show you maybe some of the time. The cover page talks about or displays the beautiful smiling faces of the vegetable vendors in one of the streets of Mizoram. That is the beauty of the book and the gist of the writing. That if you can spread happiness, nothing like that, as Bhutan says, GDH, gross domestic happiness, as the 9th MDG, Millennium Development Goal. Friends, in India, we have got 6 women universities and more than 100 women study centers in universities, colleges, and institutes. When we talk about the first thing, then Bombay and present day Mumbai, SNDT University in 1974 had the first women study center. And today they also host Indian Women Study Association, in which friends, men and women both are members. We all can become members of that association. They don't restrict it to only women. Then coming to the 93 universities in which we have women study centers, nearby we have got Guwahati, Dibrugarh, Manipur, Tejpur, Nagaland and Arunachal. Mizoram is added today. Then nearby in the region we have in Kolkata, Jadavpur, Vishwabharati, and till far away but closely linked to us is Nagpur, JNU, New Delhi, Jamia Millia, JNU and many other institutes and universities who can guide us. In fact, Professor Nilima Deshmukh from Nagpur was one of the resource persons guiding our department to frame the basics of this study center. Then coming to components, friends, it starts from sociology, psychology, philosophy, politics, public administration, history, to many other walks of life where women are very much present, from media to politics, to health, to industry, to agriculture, to space science. Anything, anywhere, when they work, their issues, concerns, problems, and the way forward, this can be discussed in Women's Study Center. And for our Women's Study Center, as Professor Jobi rightly pointed out, we have study, research, documentation, publication, training, advocacy, extension activities, and many other courses like orientation, refresher, we can do that. Friends, this center is a beginning in the sense that many times in Mizoram University, elsewhere in Mizoram, people talk about the activities, the contribution, achievements of Mizo women, but seldom recognized in many places. The point is, you go anywhere, you can find them, but still with some kind of recognition, this will go places. So this study center will be a step towards that direction. And our university has the motto, greater deeds remain. This occasion, I would also like to thank our Honorable Vice Chancellor, under whose guidance we could do this and still we can go greater heights. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Our next speaker on women's studies is Dr. T. Vanlaltani. May I now call upon her to kindly render her speech. Professor T. Vanlaltani is a professor at ATC Aizawl Theological College. She is the first woman professor of the college and has a number of publications on women's issue. She is also a member of the State Commission for Women, Mizoram.
Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mizoram University, Professor Alal Thantuanga, Chairperson of the Technical Session, and all those important invitees for this inauguration of Women's Studies Center in Mizoram University, and all the students in this university who are gathering here, I feel a great privilege to stand before you and give a speech. Being given 10 minutes, I don't know how I will be able to manage. So to shorten my speech, I have prepared a small paper. I will just read, and I hope I will be able to finish within 10 minutes or little more than that. In case I don't finish within 10 minutes, please excuse me. First, let me express my sincere congratulations to Mizoram University for reaching a golden step in which women are given sincere attention with the aim to understand the wholeness of humanity without any gender bias upon the complete humanity. I want to give special appreciation to the efforts put by the Vice Chancellor to really materialize the vision of those whose hope was lying in the air. To look and talk about women's studies globally, its specific study was given attention only in the second half of 20th century, even in the first world country. The first accredited women's studies course was recorded being held in 1969 in Cornell University. And the first women's studies program in the United States was established in 1970 at San Diego State College, that later became university. Talking the importance and significance of having women's study center, students under this program are led and expected to analyze gender, race, sexuality, life condition of women along with their suffering and struggle, and the factors causing such with the search for the solution. They learn through analysis, work in the community and research, and try to make their findings relevant to the context of their living environment. They study how to make use of a theoretical tool set to put into practice for making social change when and where necessary, and for doing away the power inequalities due to difference in sex and status. They do this for making better future in which women and men would know how to live with better relationship without any gender barrier. One, Women's Study Center in India. In India, the University Grants Commission started the strengthening program of women's studies since the 7th plan period. The 11th plan took a broader view of women's studies to support upgradation of the Women's Study Center in universities and colleges in teaching and research projects. The 12th plan of UGC gave emphasis on equity and inclusiveness and took gender as a major concern. It also emphasized the importance of taking initiative for leadership development at all levels. It is recorded that the 12th plan poses new challenges of consolidation, innovation, developing interdisciplinary approaches, evolving theory and new strategies of pedagogy to grapple with the complexities of caste, class, gender, ethnicity, regional and religious diversity, and so on. UGC is very much in favor of establishing Women's Studies Center for empowering women, encouraging and strengthening women in order to let women able to work with men at the level of their life, at all the levels of their life. Two, historical retrospect to effort given for the establishment of Women's Study Center in Mizoram University. By knowing the interest of UGC for empowerment of women through education and special study on women, plus looking at the condition and the need of women in Mizoram, the Panchayat Mahila Shakti Abhiyan Core Committee in...
I also would like to give an appeal that this is the beginning of this Women's Study Center. Then in near future, even in future also, the cooperation, the support, the encouragement, the help from the society, from the university authority, and then from the teacher, the student, and the scholar is going to be very much required. For that, I have actually submitted my appeal to give without limitation, I mean, your help, so that in the academic venture, Women's Study Center can also prosper in giving a good contribution to the society. I once again welcome each and every one of you from the core of my heart, and may God bless you all. Thank you.
Let us now call our first speaker of the day, Professor. The reception people are requested to kindly move the lectern to the middle.
Sir Professor R. Lathamtuama, Vice Chancellor, Mizoram University, distinguished guests of honor and speakers, Professor S. Pathy, Dean School of Social Sciences, Professor T. Vandalthani, ISO Theological College, Ms. Lalbyakimi, Dr. R. Lanunmoi, Dr. Thanpui, and Professor Zhou Kaituani, Dr. Reverend R.L. Nooney, the officers of Mizoram University, deans, school of, schools in the university, prominent citizens, my esteemed senior and junior colleagues, and officers in Mizoram University, the distinguished guests, friends, and ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, let me begin by expressing warm welcome to all of you to the inauguration of Women's Study Center in the Mizoram University. I would like to take undue opportunity to express my sincerest gratitude to the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor R. Lathamtuama, for making his time available to join us and grace the occasion as a chief guest today. As we all know, he has got so many academic works, administrative works to perform. So in spite of all this, having neck deep work to carry out in his dignified office, he is with us. Let us welcome him with a big hand. Ladies and gentlemen, let me share this. It is because of our Honorable Vice Chancellor, today's important program is possible. It is due to his painstaking efforts the Women's Study Center has been established in our university with effect from 1st April 2016. So this gathering is a special and it is the first of its kind. So I may be permitted to recognize the presence of the distinguished special invitees in our midst for whom or for which invitation have been extended. So ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome officers and staff, Department of Social Welfare, Government of Mizoram. Dr. Mimi is here. Officers and staff, Mizoram State Commission for Women. Then leaders of MHEP General Headquarters, the present and the previous, the past. Pirin Tuami, Pisang Kumi, and who else? Even Pirau. Pizzo Pari also. Anyway, it's all right. I'm going to call you. Then former members, core committee, PMSA, Panchayat Mahila Sakti Abhiyan, Piduni, Pitlani, and then who all are here. Then leaders of Live Women Association, LWA. Then leaders of Chakma Mahila Samiti. Then Gurkha Mahila Samiti. No. Then Mizo Mechetangdwal. Mizo Mechetangdwal, Pisang Luri. And who else are here? I don't know. Then Society for Economic Upliftment. then Councillor AMC past and present. AMC, Aizawl Municipal Council, now Aizawl Municipal Corporation. Okay. Then we have P. Kansiami P. Siamtei, ex MLA. Then media like Doordarshan Kendra, radio, local and newspaper, local channels and all, and newspaper. Pizopui, officers and staff of radio also, I have seen them in our midst. Then chairman and staff, State Social Welfare Board. Chairman and staff, State Social Welfare Board. Then leaders of all Mizoram Women Federation. Then ATUI, Association of Theologically Trained Women of India, Mizoram chapter. Pitani can, I think, stand up. Also, yes. Then human rights and law networking. Human rights and law networking. Then principals and faculties. Aizawl-based colleges, like Dr. R.K. Kolni, I have seen him in our midst. I could spot him. Teachers of Aizawl-based college. Then CPD, leaders of CPD. No. Then may I also let us recognize leaders of MEFCO, Ubela and Pizopari, Pinikui, I don't know, okay. Then teachers in the Mizoram University and officers, I think I should not ask you to stand up from your chair. So ladies and gentlemen, and then I also welcome the teachers in the universities. I also welcome the research scholar and students of my Mizoram University. So it is actually a very happy occasion, as we all know today, as we are now, attending this very important program, that is inauguration of Women's Study Center in the Mizoram University. I shouldn't take long. So ladies and gentlemen, let me share this. It is because of our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Aral Tantuanga, today's function is possible. So the former core committee, Panchayat Mahila Sakti Abhiyan, saw today, some few years ago. So the core committee, Panchayat Mahila Sakti Abhiyan's charter of demand for women political empowerment movement that has been set up by the government of Mizoram way back in 2008 and continued till 2011. So with the direction of the Minister of Panchayati Raj, this committee has been in operation for some periods. So they have submitted 7 pages long to the government of India, even to the government of Mizoram, and a roadmap has also been prepared. And establishment of Women's Study Center is one of the demands that dream is now come true. So let us give a big hand to say thank you to the authority, especially Professor Lal Thantuanga, who is in our midst, and to inaugurate this Women's Study Center. Let us give a big hand to say thank you. So let me just attempt this only one thing. As we all know that our society is a man-made or a dominated, male-dominated society where women do not have voice in almost aspects of life. This has greatly affected the well-being of men and women in the society. So therefore, to bring a change towards this end, many efforts have been put and steps have been taken by the government of India, even at the international level also. So establishment of Women's Study Center, as it was already announced or was already shared by the COMPARE, in the universities and colleges is one of the most important steps that have been taken by the government. As of now, there are more than 160 Women's Study Centers across the nation. So one of the main aims and objective of this Women's Study Center is to make invisible women in the society visible, as their contribution in the society are not duly recognized. So towards this end, with this, Women's Study Center will function in the Mizoram University also. There are so many other main aims and objectives also. So we know that even in the Mizo society also, the contribution of women is too great than, most of the contribution that have been made by the women are not recognized even in this society. So for this also, this Women's Study Center is going to work for this. Then I should not take so long, so I should also thank, to each and every one of you. I think I may have missed out, some of the representatives who have been invited and then attend in this very hall, witnessing this very function also. So anyway, I welcome each and every one of you once again, and then I thank you.
students for that mesmerizing song.
Thank you. Mizorami.
Women's studies was introduced into National Policy of Education 1986, and this is a breakthrough for the women. Currently, there are 159 women's studies centers established in various universities and colleges.
Sing the day.
something young there wrong and then wrong, Yaminana Sari. Something young, Yaminini was only Sanya Yarin, Tanta Sera, Mongaiin, Jumpwit Yam, Him and Tori, Tansanya Yarsela.
Ching Don, Mizoram University Zara, Mizoram Dung Le Vanga, Minu, Meitia Deu, Longai Charu, Turuk in Tupro, we high swap Turin, Itan Puolani, Women Study Center, Kandram Kalsiam, Tidanglam, Turin, Ron Loi Vero, Mizoram University, Nyea, Izara, Tiam Narotling, Ne Turin, Mizoram Kalsiam, Tidanglama, Matiang Sonin, Junghua Nuhol Him Nazara, Kempas Chung, Mun Fai Le Thiang Him Mipui Nong Pui Nan Tlo Chak, Mizoram University, Vul Ze Rok Se, Gan Lo Me.
Leave a minute. We shall now call upon a group recipient.